I had occasion to hear the speech of a member from Kerala, Ajahn Vitas. Wonderful. Really. I enjoyed it. Next day, to my disappointment, not even a single line of what he spoke in the house was reported in the national media.
Next speaker is John Vitas. This is your maiden speech, so your time is 15 minutes.
Honorable Law Minister Kiran Riju has made it clear that the purpose of this bill is to make the legislative intent clear about the additional quantum of pension. Fair, sir. I fully appreciate it. But does he understand there is a serious lacuna, because though we decide on such matters, we have no role in the appointment of judges. Sir, does this exist anywhere in the world, sir? Absolutely no. Judges appointing judges is unheard. Let people know who are going to be our judges and their competence, ability, integrity. Should there be a system shrouded in mystery, secrecy, and darkness? Sir, only in India. And the law minister is mute spectator of the system. Sir, let me read out a profile of a judge which I happen to see in a High Court website. Please allow me to do so. Mr. Justice so-and-so, I won't mention his name. Born on so-and-so date. Belongs to a family associated with judges. His maternal great-grandfather, a Chief Justice of India. Maternal grandfather was a former acting Chief Justice. One of his maternal uncle, former Judge of Supreme Court. His maternal uncle, Honorable Justice, sitting Supreme. It's gone on, sir. It's like a long list.
Very long.
Sir, we all talk about dynasty, sir. The BJP members have been very harsh when they talk about dynasty in Congress party, sir. At least they have passed the test of winning the confidence of the people. Sir, this is a clear case of dynasty. Clear cut of dynasty. Why are we keeping mum on this, sir? And sir, what did our former law minister, late Arun Jaitley, he said? There are two kinds of judges. He said so. Those who know the law and those who know the law minister. We are the only country in the world where judges appoint judges. Does it mean that when it comes to judiciary, we shouldn't want such a diverse representation? Should we be oblivious about that? You want only representation in the cabinet? Sir, out of 47 Chief Justices of India till date, at least 14 have been Brahmins. From 1950 to 1970, the maximum strength of the Supreme Court was 14 judges and 11 of them were Brahmins. Sir, 1971 to 1989, Kiran Riju saab. Sir, this is a point, sir. This is a point.
Please.
This is a point.
Please.
Sir, this is a point.
Please. Please, man.
I am saying there is no diversity in judiciary. Sir,
please,
sir,
please.
This is a maiden speech.
Me.
Sir, I am interrupted.
Agar hoga to delete kara denge.
I want
to delete kara denge.
Sir, I want your protection, sir. Sir, I want your protection.
Aap samapt kijiye, please.
Sir, I am going to complete it.
Please,
sir, please. Sir, chhod
abo
comments.
Agar aisi koi cheez hogi to usko delete kar.
Sir, please allow me.
Delete kar denge.
Sir, 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 I
please conclude.
Please
conclude now.
I am not
please
against any caste.
Please conclude now.
I am not against any caste, sir.
Thank you, Mr. John.
Sir, I am just completing.
Thank
sir.
You.
Will this August House be shocked to note that till 1980, there was no judge from the OBC or Supreme SC in the highest court
Thank
of
you.
This country? Sir, I am sure the key framer of the Constitution and first Law Minister, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, will be turning in his grave, seeing how judicial appointments are made and how the independence of judiciary is tampered with.